We've finished our clinical evaluation, we've analyzed the data, and now the ultimate question is, do we have sufficient clinical evidence? And clinical evidence is defined in the MDR. It really comes down to whether you have sufficient amount and quality of data to allow for the assessment. The MedEv actually defines sufficient clinical evidence, the amount and quality of clinical evidence to guarantee the scientific validation of the conclusions, in this case of the CER. When you look at your data set as a whole, it may feel like sufficient data, but when you really get into the weeds of it, there are pieces that are missing. These are the ones we commonly see. The first one, data for each device or variant. So using a simplistic example of a trauma plate, let's say you have two plate variants, they have different designs or maybe slightly different indications that warrant them to stand alone in the CER. In these cases, the expectation is you have sufficient data to support each variant on their own. If you do not, you know, this may be where equivalence comes into play. Two is data on all indications. So sticking with that simplistic example of the trauma plate, let's say the plate is indicated for fracture fixation and osteotomy. The expectation is that there are sufficient data for each clinical use. The third bullet, data on all anatomical locations, using that trauma plate as an example. You know, these are typically intended to be used throughout the body. The tibia, femur, humerus, clavicle. The expectation is you have data, or maybe a justification, on each of these anatomical locations. Fourth bullet is the unanswered questions on long-term safety and performance. I do not have a definition for you on what long-term is. It varies, there's justification that goes into it, but I will say that you need to consider if you have data to support your full device lifetime. Last bullet, if you're using equivalent comparator data, then you obviously have at least one device that does not have sufficient data on its own. Now, any of these gaps may be identified, but it doesn't necessarily mean you won't be able to draw the appropriate conclusions and demonstrate conformity with the relevant general safety and performance requirements.